Well, welcome back to Chinkie Chong place in the Gungeon. First pirate? Nope, not the bullet. Put that on. I like the potential of playing as the pilot. Most of the time because of the chance where you can just get free item from the chest. Well, although there's a risk that you just wrecked up the chest and not get anything. With the railgun. No need to wait for any longer, maybe we can get in this run. So, anyway. And although I really don't like the starting weapon, probably one of the worst. At the moment, I would say it's worse than even a convex revolver because it doesn't get benefit from tap shooting. It doesn't shoot any faster, it just like that. That's the fastest fire it can go. So although the convex revolver only got 5 shots, but it scales with the tap shooting, so in that matter, this one is not the best gun out of all the characters. But I think it's okay. But a counterpoint is that you do have 2 passive items and then an active item, so I think it balances out. Which means that you can potentially get more different guns in the run from the shop or other source of item gaining. AKA chess. Alright, took that bit of damage. I think it's okay. If I can go for the. Ooh. If I can get the elevator shortcut with the 6th part, that's fine. We'll do it. If not, then. It won't worry too much about it because someday. Someday we're gonna get it. But for now, I think. A good strategy is find a way to stack up some more money because buying stuff in the shop as the pilot gets a discount. The perk of being a captain, although you're just a pilot, you've got to bargain. Bargain your way to get a cheaper capacitor for your crappy little ship that smuggles stuff, or bargain your way out into dangerous situation. Don't bargain your way into a dangerous situation. That's the last bit you want. Because being a pilot of a spaceship, you are basically a trouble magnet. You're there to do cause trouble, get yourself into the right very dead middle of it. So yeah, we try not to do it. Alright. I never really noticed the green visor that on the pilot's ultimate skin. I think it's a really nice touch on it. Pretty sci-fi-y. Although it's more late 80s to 90s sci-fi style. I don't know who else wears a visor now, not even V-Jet. When it's over 9,000 of rock, then you just drop it because there's no point. Alright, first chest. Just a green one, I will take my chances and I fail. Oh shit, open. Get some junk out of it. Am I a bit reckless for doing that at first? Just maybe, but I feel like it. I think that makes me feel better. You know, hey, at least I saved a key in some way. Yeah. Although I could have checked in the chest first, it doesn't quite matter. We'll be fine. We can save one key for later stuff. And here's a shop in the next room. That final hit just a bit too late. Now it's not gonna do anything. Okay. How do I want to set this one now? I mean, I'm still in the run. First of all, I don't have much of a choice, but if I can. Oh, these two are very nice indeed. They're very expensive though, but these two, 30, 38, so 68 coins is not impossible. In fact, it's very doable. So the Gun Knight Gauntlet will give you armor on pickup. I forget it's 1 armor or 2 armor on pickup, but every time you go to a new floor, you get a new armor. We get a gun out of it, that's fine. I like the mailbox. So, and then there's a sling. I totally want a sling. Very nice charge weapon with that also do humongous amount of damage. Right. the mailbox, the last shot will be a parcel that does status attack. It's another grid. Oh, I should have reloaded. We'll open it now, and it's the easy reload. So every time when you roll, you reload one bullet. If you can get this thing, it's perfectly useful. Hard and blank, pretty solid, I think. Alright, so I think it's playing out really well. I do want to get both of the items in that shop. Oh my god. Wifey Shrine, every time you, well, you start by paying the shrine 10 coins, and every time you pay 10 more, and then every time you, the more you use the shrine, the higher the chance that you can get a passive, where when you shoot, you can get a chance to shoot 2 to 4 extra pellets. Very useful. By this, I'm not sure if it's perfectly useful to use that, to use a YV shrine or with the sling. Let's just put it this way, I don't think I can buy the Gunlight Gauntlet in this level now. So I'm just gonna fight the boss. Maybe I made a bad decision, but I think that's how it is. I think it's better than sacrificing two items and just go for the Wifey Shrine twice. Because it, without a solid gun, it's not very desirable. So yeah, I think I made the right choice there. And if the boss dropped me some money, I mean, I can still use a Wifey Shrine once after the boss fight, because I start with 10 points, so that's fine. Yeah, it didn't drop me a lot of money, so... Oh, wait, that changes everything. It changes every single thing. Okay, so now we can go buy the Gunlight Gauntlet. But before we do that, so... Let's do some math here. So the first time with Wifey Shrine is going to be 10, and the second time is 20, so it comes to 30, and it'll be 60. So, instead of buying the Gauntlet, I can use Wifey Shrine for 3 times. But now, if I buy the Gauntlet, it will come down to 42 coins. So 42 will count as 40 because it doesn't matter, so we can use 2 times. So I think I can justify with using that, but I mean buying the Gauntlet and then going Wifey Shrine twice, because I think, look, the second time and third time, I think though, doesn't have that much of a difference. But by saving the 30 coins on the third time, we got a Gunlet's Gauntlet, basically two armors, because we got one right now, and then when we go to the next floor, we get one right afterwards. So I think that I can totally justify with that. Okay, and yeah, that triple crossbow isn't that good to my liking, so you should slow bolts, and then when you reload, you shoot triple bolts. So that's what's special about it. I think I like it that much, and it will save the sling. We'll save the sling for the boss. So now let's use the triple crossbow because I don't like it. So yeah, you can see it got a snail sign on top of the head, which means they're being slowed. That's about it. You can see that was like a pile of bolt came out, so that's why Wifey Shrine activated. I'll probably try not to use the slow bolt so much. I'm gonna shoot once and then reload, maybe. Doesn't mean that, hey, since we've got the easy reload bolt, so if we shoot once and then we dot roll, oh, it doesn't change, but it does reload. Unless you do the manual changing, I think. There we go. Good. So, which means now we shoot twice and then we just dodge roll, and we'll never go back to their slow bolts. That's interesting. Now, that easy reload bolt is gonna make it so much more valuable for the triple crossbow. So now, it'll always be the triple bolt because it will always be dodge roll anyway. So twice, just make sure you don't shoot the third one, because once you do it, I think it will go back to the slow bolt. Might want to test it out actually. Okay, so I did reload. So 1, 2, 3. We do reload. Okay. So we can shoot the third one. We can shoot the third one. That's good news. That's good. Alright, so we shoot 3 times, and then make sure that afterwards you just go dodge roll. Coin crown and helix, they're both very good. I want to buy the coin crown, like badly. It can generate a lot of money in the long term. Oh no, shouldn't have done the reload. Good. Oh no. Okay, gotta get used to this. No, not now. Not now. The other two guns are too valuable for me to drop it. For the gun launcher. Oh my god. Okay, gotta be careful. I can do this. I know that I can. Not now, but thank you. So, I would like to take as little damage as possible. Plus, I want to get the flaws out of it. Okay. I better just do 2 shots and then reload. I think that works out a bit better. Because when I see the reload on top of the head, I will just press R and reload. That doesn't work out very good. Right, okay, yeah, let's hide in there. Good, good, good. I think that works out a lot better. There we go. Very nice. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, we find your rhythm. Or find a way to work. Rhythm is just a nicer way of saying that things are working now. Good, 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 good. Very nice. We go out of the room and dodge it. Okay, 39 coins. We're getting there for the coin crown. We want more money. So that way we can give you chests. Oh, okay, that's too... That's too important to use the lockpick on, so I won't. I won't take the risk on that one. But yeah. Deal with those guys, what happened? Okay, go back to the triple crossbow. Nope, nope, nope. Okay. Gotta go back into there. Happen again. Good, good, good. Not very, not very. It's not actually that intense, I just make it that way. Because I really want this to work. It's hard to normally make this work. And with the easy reload bullet, it is working, so I want to make this work. I want to keep this working. So that's why I'm a bit intense over there. So now I failed again. So shoot that once, slow him, do the manual reload. There you go. Much better, much better. Good. And the fact is I want to make this work while not taking so much damage. That's a big one. Alright, we'll go this way. You know what, we can buy the coin crown now. How much are the keys here now? 26, so 26 plus 46 would be 72. We're missing a bit, so I won't buy it now. I want to make sure I can open the black chest. Although coins in the long run are much more valuable, I want to see what option I have, if at all. Use that one, no need for the crossbow. Triple crossbow. Whoa, that's unfair. Alright, but we're still going. Good. The thing is, someone's do it, you know, according to plan, things should work out pretty nicely. Alright, that's a bit more. 1, 2, watch roll. Make sure you don't manual reload that one. Alright, it's just a green one, I'm open. Go screw yourself too. Pick it up, that's fine. NPC maybe? No, of course it's not. 72 coins, we're missing just a little. So 9 coins, it seemed to be a bit tricky. So you know what, let's do the boss first, and then I'll figure out a way to do it. Sling and the mailbox. And we'll call this should be fine if we're using the sling. I can hear the thing come out. Good, good, good. Glad I have extra blank that I can use. Okay, that wasn't ideal. It got fucked up. Try to kill that thing in time. Use a blank. So I'm right in the middle of those sour worms. I know they're not sour worms, but I don't know what to call them. Okay. I think I'm the one making it intense, but I want this to work. Okay, you know what? Never mind. Okay. Still dodging all those stuff. Alright, not ideal. Definitely not ideal. I was expecting to get a flawless out of it. But we did get money out of it, so. Still a shotgun, I think is the one that you charge it up, is it? Let's have a look. A 4-barrel shotgun that can be fired at once. Yep, so that's the one you charge and then fire. Alright, so what do we want to do now? Now, I haven't found a secret room yet, I've got no blanks left. Oh, okay, that's good. Not a lot of anvils though. Gotta be realistic here. Alright. can I buy both? Yeah, 46 and 26 is 60 and 72. Can't buy both as well. I will take my chances and use a lockpick. Can't fail the third time. There we go. And what did we get? Oh, okay, I think it worked out pretty nicely. Very nicely, I gotta say. I got 24 coins still. Anything I can buy? No, not a key, no nothing. No gun muncher, so we'll be on our way. That's good. I want to see how strong this gun would be. I'm trying to click the mouse around and see what it does. And I hope it doesn't like prematurely fire shot there, which it didn't, so I'm grateful for that. Okay. I think despite the fact that we didn't get the flaws, things worked out okay. Okay, so we're still using the triple crossbow here. Make sure to stay that way. Good, good. So, it's like playing a new game that I'm playing, Crypt of Necrodancer, so you've got to figure out what you want to do. It's like hit, shoot, and then dodge roll, and shoot, and then dodge roll, or shoot twice, and then dodge roll twice. Mix and match, oh my god. Oh yeah, I did get an armor because of the gauntlet. Alright, okay, sure. Yep, I'll give it that one. Very lucky. Mutation. Never really a big fan of it. It's like a pretty disgusting thing. Reminds me of Prototype, the other video game that came with two episodes. Not episodes, but one and two, pretty much. Never really played it. Always wanted to. Anyway. This good old room here shouldn't be a big problem with the triple crossbow. Not throw. Good. Ooh, okay. Nice. So, every time you fire it, so every bolt seems to have a chance to trigger YV's blessing. Seems to be though, I'm not entirely sure. But, it feels good when it triggers, so you can see a line of bolts being fired like that. Oh no. Anyway, so we just quickly reload if it swapped to slow bolts. That, you die in this one. Two. Four. 83, so I can give it a sling, can I? Oh, I already did, so. Sealer shotgun is fine. That one I didn't care about that much, so we'll give it back to the triple crossbow. Certainly it's interesting to make this work. So it's an interesting synergy that I didn't expect at all. Okay. Taking a lot of necessary damage here. So when it requires a lot of motions or movements, this is not a very good weapon at all. And this is killing me. Although the knockback is awesome. Okay, finally. Okay, that went horribly wrong. I shouldn't have stuck with the crossbow in that room. I mean, in just then. Alright, that was a bit of compensation. Alright. Maybe I should try to seal a shotgun. You know, at least find out what it does. Although I assume just a very awesome knockback and bouncing bullets. Good, you know what? I do decide to give it a shot. And then you have a reload every time like that. Okay, it's like a different version of the Corsair. But then, you know, I got the easy reload, so every time I can just keep dodge rolling and reload. Ammo belt seemed to be great, I will buy it now. And just hopefully we'll keep the ammo drop going. Like just then. Very good. Go down. Go down. Reload. Certainly makes reloading easier for guns that doesn't have a lot of ammo capacity. Alright, kill the burger when possible. Because that one's close enough. Ooh. Right, open your eyes there. 1, 2, 3, dodge roll. 1, 2, nice. Alright, now things are going back there. Got the rhythm back. Those hips don't lie. Very good. Okay. Find a way to replenish your health. Ooh. Dangerous. I did buy the coin crown for the sake of getting more money. I don't see how it's working out for us now. I'm not sure if I need to play like brilliantly in a room for that to pay out. I hope not, because that would be a big problem. Because I don't play well. Nope, don't hit that one just yet. We reload here, since no one can come to you. Alright, that didn't hit me. Good news. There. Good, 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 good. Alright. Surprisingly, I expect myself to take a lot of damage over there. Okay. Kill the big mushroom when possible. There, and there. Small mushroom now. I wonder when next time YV's shrine will trigger. Just then, that's good. We need, of course we want YV's shrine to trigger more, because that's definitely gonna help a lot. It does, you know, 2 to 4 times more damage, although not exactly, because I think only one of the bolts get doubled. But still, you know, theoretically, not theoretically, but it will do more damage than your normal shot. That was close. There we go. Maybe a big guy here. We need that big guy for our bounty, so that's good. 1, 2, 3. Good. That should kill him. One, two. Fine, one more. Three. There we go. There we go. Three. I saw the cock of battle in the shop, but I don't think it's gonna work well for us with the triple, not triple crossbow, the easy reload casing. Because we reload by dodge rolling most of the time, so we don't see the bar over there to reload that. So I don't see how that's gonna work for us. Oh, that'd be so good. I've no reason to use the hairpin now, because if I need to spend the money, I can spend the money. And you know, I took the risk to open the black chest with the hairpin already in the last floor, so I don't want to do it a second time. I want to do it the proper way, hopefully. Three. Nice. Nice. Yep. A shop's over there. I forgot. I access the shop already. My key. Open the chest. And hope for the best. You hope for the chest and then you hope for the best. Alright, there we go.
Ooh.
Six chamber, so every curse will give you a bit of damage up. So by picking it up you get one curse, so you already get one damage up. I kinda wanna get rid of the triple crossbow. It's gonna kill me very shortly. Especially in level 4, so I just don't know what gun to put in for the second one. So did I find a second item room already? Oh yeah, I did. Okay. So boss room already, we'll use the ram gun. We'll get that. Not sure about the, oh my gosh, not sure about the yellow aiming laser. But that bouncing part is good. That should do multiple damage, is it? Yep, it does. So horizontally or vertically, is the way to go. So when it's moving, better don't shoot. Alright, so wait for it to stop. There we go. Quickly. That didn't aim that well. Like that. Nope. But I can see it hit more than once. Good, good, good. How does it work? They go straight line like that, I guess. What are we doing it though? I mean, we have 44 shots, now 36, so less than 10 shots. It's already dying. Okay. Sadly, I didn't get the flawless here as well. Oh, very nice. Oh, just a bit over 10 shots, precisely about 11. What is this? Liquid Valkyrie, maximum pain. Max pain. Slows enemy projectiles. Yep, max pain. Greatly increased reaction time with few side effects. Commonly used by rebel forces before raids on her Germany outposts. Okay, give a backstory about it. It doesn't quite matter which gun. You know what? I want to use the gun launcher. I'm gonna take a big risk. I'm gonna use it and put the crossbow and the sealer shotgun in there. Why would I want to make such a decision? I don't see myself using those two guns, and those two guns, even if I use, I can see them killing me. So, and it totally pays out. So I'd rather take the chance and it pays off. Like, massively. So I can use the mailbox and the mutation for our main weapon. Do I want to find out where the secret room is? I probably do. I check the shop. Yep, I won't shoot, that's fine. Honestly, I have no idea. I don't want to just go shoot anywhere I want this time. I just don't want to waste the ammo on that. But I don't seem to have a choice, so you know what, just give up. I'd rather save a flank for the next floor. I think that's a slightly better decision to make. And since we're slightly behind the schedule. Oh, okay. Alright, take a sip of my tea here. Alright, good. I don't like how it reloads my gun when you go to the new floor. I was set to make a parcel for the first shot in the level. But it isn't working. We'll get the letters. Nice. Good, good, good. That parcel missed. Delivery. Does it mean that, you know, shoot the parcel, reload, you'll always get the parcel? Interesting. Not very efficient, sure. Interesting. Hell yeah. But it just means that every shot is on. I thought every shot is gonna be poison. That doesn't seem to be. Alright, oh, okay. Didn't mean to reload that one, but it doesn't matter because it's better than reload the whole clip or magazine. I don't know what a mailbox uses. Oh, look at that. So clear that doesn't mean anything, I think. Someone there. There you go. So when you do explosions, that's probably the best you can get out of it. Nice. But other than that, poison would be very good too. I don't know if glitter does anything. There you go. Alright. Very good. Very good. And if time comes to a situation where it's like really urgent, then I can dodge roll or reload. That doesn't matter. Oh, look at the pile of things. Alright. Very nice. And when I say things, I mean the parcel. Wasn't happy about the damage either. Nice. Yeah, it's certainly not efficient, but it's very, very fun. You know, all you have to do is just skip dodge rolling, and then every shot you have is gonna be the parcel. Okay. Nice. Okay. Yep, take the poison. Oh, man. That's a lot of waste. Okay, so we refilled the ammo, so now we're gonna shoot all the pile. Just make sure you get the setup back to where it was, and you'll be okay. That's so nice. Never noticed a way of playing it like that. Yeah, I would have thought of it if I didn't experience it myself. That's fine. Very nice. So which means that every gun that has the special last shot will do the same thing. So say for the judge, light gun, they all do the same thing. So right now I don't have any guns, anything else that does the same thing. You get what I mean. Wow. So that certainly changes the whole game. How come I didn't thought of it earlier? Alright. Good. And we're still doing fine, actually. Surprisingly. Good. Wow, pretty high damage too. So we don't mind getting a bit more cursed, that would just increase our damage. Well, and maybe the chance of getting the jammed enemies, but that's a good deal. Because parcels can basically do higher damage in one shot. Just depends on which one you get. Didn't kill it. Come on. There we go, that's what we want. Oh, nice. There has to be a better gun with the last shot. I'm sure there would be a lot, actually. Icebreaker? Definitely one of them. And it's not just the easy reload bullet that can make it interesting, it's also the fact that we have the... What do we have? The Wifey Shrine. Because we can shoot a pile of... parcels. That. Oh, very good. Keep those and we'll come. I can refill this one. Or maybe that one. And then come back to the parcel and then got reloaded. Dang it. That's what I don't like about it. Ah, worry not though. Once we reach the parcel, we're gonna do the same thing anyway. Oh, parcel ready. I don't think it's Warmonger, so it could be the other two, Chi Pillar or the High Priest. Isn't that very good? That gives me a curse, doesn't it? No. Rolling Eye. Oh, is it when you roll, you rebound? Yeah, you bounce back the bullets to enemies. That's very good. So we're having those upgrades just on the right part that focus on the stuff we want to. So dodge rolling and the reloading. Very good. Sweet. Okay, now ammo for that. Go that way. Haven't found a shop yet. And we didn't get a single key in the whole playthrough. Take that too. Ooh, okay, that was so close. Sweet. Alright, you take the parcel when you're ready. Sign here. Oh my god. Okay, that somehow worked. Good. Blank. Sure. Because I've got like 400 shots of parcels to deliver. If you want me to do more, that's totally fine. It's not gonna change my mind. Use that to find out the secret rooms around. Use airpin as well. That's fine. Should have found a shop first. Good, and get a gun out of it. It's a flash ray that I'm not too interested in. So I'm fine with it, but I'll go explore the rest of the floor. Go find the shop, maybe an interesting NPC. Okay, there's a gun over there. Okay, good. Oh, that one doesn't take poison damage, that explains everything. Go that way, see what you've got for me. Magnum and keys. Magnum and keys. Both doesn't interest me at all. So I can save some money for whatever we can use for next time. So all I need is just shooting parcels and wait for Wifey Shrine to pop, if it ever does, or like just then. Good. Very nice. So for anyone who doesn't take poison damage, that'll be a bit annoying. Because then we'll keep shooting until we get explosives to them. Go back to good old railgun. Shot there. It's good. That. Oh, okay. That's probably the worst kind of dodging, where you dodge it and you back it up into it. I'm trying to line it up to make the best shot out of it. I don't think it's working really well. Didn't take as much damage as I would like it to. Actually, it does. Nice. Like that. Okay, sure. That was a bit annoying. But as long as I dodge roll, I can dodge roll through it. Okay. Probably not the best practice, but we're still okay. We're still okay. No, wait. We're still out okay. Just not so okay. Not as okay as before. Oh my god, did you see that? I bounced that shot back into it and killed it. Interesting. That wasn't planned at all. Back that one, and mutation. No ammo drop, but the armors are good, and the hexagon. Hexagon is gonna be really interesting as well. So we can use hexagon, shoot, and then dodge roll, shoot, and dodge roll. No hard round, but not check the shot. For no reason. Probably run away. Oh, okay. That's an NPC round, so I think I want to buy a key. Then. That is worthwhile to buy a key for. Because it's totally not worthwhile. Maybe a secret room be here? Not here. Where would the secret room be? You know what, I don't care. Alright, found a rock. So we've got a pretty interesting way to do things now. Because the parcels are good, but the hexagon will be slightly more effective against enemy. So we'll just dodge rolling and keep shooting. I think that can... That's a bit better. So at the end of the day, that's a bit more basic, yet effective. Don't get me wrong, but I definitely enjoy the parcel part of it. I don't think the dodge rolling is working because once I shoot it, it reloads itself. So, okay, no. I just have to dodge roll right after I shoot. Good. Yeah, also I think it's working out pretty nicely. That. Careful with that. Alright. Exactly what. Why? When I don't have to dodge roll to reload, I don't have to. One thing to know about it. Careful with that. Good. Keep going this way. That's a two-way. Never seen that. Two exits? Man, that's unnecessary. Where's the other one? There. Are you somewhere there? I wonder if you can actually kill the ham. Maybe you can. Sure, go back that way. I'll explore that part first. Because that's pretty short distance to run. You literally just go from here and there. Another gun launcher. Sure, I can give you a light ray. Flash ray. It's not very good anyway. And then I can give you maybe the mutation. I don't like it anyway. So here we go. Maybe we get lucky a second time. Nope. Not at all. Probably the worst gun you can get from them. Yeah, I still got Bundle of One, so. Oh my god, scary. So, Bundle of One is good as well, don't forget about that. Oh, you can transform that thing. So, back to the question I said, can you kill the hammer? I think same thing applies, you can transform it, and then technically, you can, you know, roll over it and kill it. I think it's a yes with conditions, so that's still a yes. Good to know. So which means that we can transmog the hammer in that very long room where the hammer just keep dropping. Yeah. Good. Jammed enemy, if you can transmog it, that would be worth it. That good. All right, Things are getting interesting now. Oh my god. Can you transform that thing? Oh. Alright. Try one more time. Okay. That wasn't planned. Okay, that's good. I'm not hitting that thing at all, and that thing's fast enough to run through that trap. Alright, so you know when you see those sci-fi movies, like say Star Trek, you see those compartment doors are like that, and then when things happen, you know, they get intruders alerted, it was like, shut the door, shut the whatever thing you call that gate, and then it was like, what if someone in the middle, wouldn't you kill it? Totally worth it. So yeah, like you would get clamped in the middle, doesn't it scare you? At least a little bit. That's for me. Okay, that wasn't a good shot at all. Okay. Good. I think we're getting a hang of it. Despite the fact we took one damage. I feel like I'm back to Counter-Strike 1.5. The good old patch where when you use a sniper rifle, AWP specifically. Once you fire a shot, you quickly swap to another weapon. If you do it quick enough, you can basically eliminate the sound of the sniper rifle. So silencer. Yeah, the good old time where you get killed without knowing what happened, because you didn't hear anything. You couldn't hear anything because pretty much there's nothing for you to hear. Okay. Running out of ammo in the hexagon. Just about now. Alright. I don't see how YB Shrine is helping with the hexagon, or maybe it did, which is officially has no difference because they would be stuck together. Maybe the beams are a little bit thicker. That's possible. So go bundle one and then the mailbox. We're getting through a level 5 pretty nicely. And you know, yeah, I mean it. Okay, it's not quick enough here though. Okay, quickly use dodge roll to replace your normal movement. Nice. Maybe, just maybe I should have used Wonder One a whole lot earlier. We'll go back to the hexagon. Dodge roll, reload, very good. Alright, and hexagon does do piercing damage, that's a good thing about it. See? Nice, okay, we're getting to the item room shortly. Alright. Walked into it, that's the worst kind of dodging. It's not even dodging. Just gotta be honest with it. I don't think I can hack the hammer. Good. Very nice. Nope. Well, I don't know if that didn't transmog it or something. Open it. Nope. Yeah, sure. Junk. There's not much we can explore, so I think the boss room will be up there, and then the gunsmith will be down there. It should be, please. Alright. Back to hexagon. That! Oh! Didn't know you can transform that one as well. I mean, if that can and transmog the block. Same thing should apply for the Gun Reaper. Should have thought of it a bit earlier. Well, good to know now. Right. Alright, so we do want to visit the gunsmith. Just to buy some stuff, because 100 something coins you can potentially buy one gun off her. You know how the price of a gun normally is. Our guns normally are. So here we go. Not yet. Should be there soon. Nice, nice. That's for one of the best level 5 fun I've ever had. Ooh, last shot. Mass shotgun's good too. Well, Judge might be better, isn't it? Because Judge's last shot it always be explosives. Although the mass shotgun's really good too. Nope, give it to the judge. Is it a good choice? Is it a good choice? I am not sure, but I think we'll give it a chance to deem itself with all these synergies. You know, it could be better. It could be better than a mailbox, and very possibly that it is. So I want to give it the possibility to find out. No flawless for the dragon, but the straight line strategy is working well. It's gonna line the shot pretty nicely. Yeah, that's working very, very well. Like that. Good. That didn't do it. Okay. Can I roll through this, Gauss? I don't want to try, but I want to know. Alright. Shot. Alright. Very good. Should have made the shot a bit quicker. Yep, I don't think it's working. That didn't kill in time. Second phase. Good. Not pretty, but quickly. That's what it counts. Okay, dodge roll these. Flying with these, because we're sort of bouncing there. And we're back as well. It's nice. That makes a whole lot of difference. There's a mouse, is something wrong with the sensor, something like it's flicking to places I don't want it to. Feels like it's not as sensitive as it normally would be. Ouch. I did it to myself. Okay, yep. Something wrong with my mouse. Right, so now we're gonna wait a bit longer. Do a swirl. Like over here. Pretty sure we can do this. Although I don't think a railgun to the hard part is the good bit. There we go. Done. There's no hard for the gun. The gunsmith to buy, so we're just gonna go down to level 6 with this. That's okay, I think. So, what's that? You know what? Maybe use the bonus once with the judge. Again, I just don't see how I can last very long in bullet hell, but. At least we're going down with synergy, so we know that it's a chance that we can do something. Alright. Pretty sweet. So. Go just. One. One. all kind of enemy we can see. Thank goodness there's a armor for me from the Gun Knight set. Okay, he's not transmogging the metal. Okay, dodge here. Very good. Ouch. Okay, I didn't get it. Okay, that wasn't me, that was a chicken. We're fine. Can you even transmog me? Quickly. Okay, you can. It just didn't pop. A wifey's shrine is popping, I saw that. Just a bit hard for me to focus now. Oh, okay. That was a big and unnecessary one. We'll give the judge a go. Hopefully it doesn't kill, so I will rather waste the ammo here so I can go in with explosions right away. It's not explosions, it's just fire damage. My misjudgment. Get it? Because it's judge. And I misjudge it. So it's pretty useless now. Okay. I sincerely apologize for the mistake I make. Where's my mailbox? Maybe some new drivers was knocking me down when trying to drive properly. So I apologize to mailbox because it seemed like the right choice is still the mailbox. Like so. Almost killing myself, so there we go. Alright, we can almost do this. Very good. I was almost certain that would be fine, except it didn't. Alright, so that's awesome synergy here. The slow projectile, although I didn't really see that working too much, or just couldn't tell. But yeah, it's definitely awesome synergy we have here. So thank you for watching. I'm going to end this here. So please consider hitting the like button or subscribing if you enjoy what you're watching. And as always, we'll see you next time. Goodbye.